Hey guys, it's me. I just wanted to basically go over a few things about Zoom. So I know a lot of people have been doing Zoom for their live streams, and I want to make sure that everybody has the best audio. So part of what Zoom has to offer people on a normal basis is a lot of echo cancellation and audio enhancing for when I'm on my computer like this. I'm using the built-in microphone. However, when you're doing a DJ stream, you're going to want to make sure that you enable a couple of things to make sure that you have a really professional sounding live stream. And here's how you do that. So first off, you're going to need to sign in to Zoom using an actual account. So you're going to need to, either create a Google account, Facebook account, or just a regular Zoom account. So I've gone ahead and logged in already with my account here. And what you're going to need to do first is whoever created the meeting, right? Whoever who's creating the meeting, whoever's the host, is going to need to go to their account, right? Zoom.us/account/settings, and then go into this option called advanced, right? So go to advanced, and you're going to see a whole bunch of options here. The ones that you really need to care about, though, are these here. These are going to start talking about the audio. Turn off DSCP marking. Typically this is only for, when you have a really slow connection. Go ahead and turn that off because otherwise it messes with people's routers sometimes. But then these two options are the critical ones here. Enabling stereo audio. Obviously you want to have a stereo sound coming out of your DJ equipment, and then obviously that needs to be transmitted to people instead of a mono, right? Which is, a really bad sounding quality. This one here is also important because the quote unquote original sound is going to be the thing that is going to basically either have the echo cancellation or not. The original sound does not put any echo cancellation on your sound. So what you hear in the DJ mixer, or coming out of the DJ mixer rather, is what your users are going to hear in the Zoom. So once you've enabled these options and disabled the DSCP one, what we're going to do is we're going to come back over here to Zoom, log into Zoom with the same account, and then click on settings. And then down here, you're going to click on audio. Okay. So when you click on audio, and you can see here, I'm talking in my audio right here, this is where you would go to enable the stereo. The next thing you're going to want to do is click on advanced. And notice here there's an option for show in meeting option to enable original sound from the microphone. Click that, and then I would also recommend disabling these advanced processing. These are relatively new, and I'm not too sure what they do. Play around with it, maybe in a test meeting prior to, and it will give you some indication of whether it will mess with your DJ set or not. As you can see here, I'm in a meeting. Basically, what you're going to want to do is before you start your gig, you're going to want to click on turn on original sounds so that it says turn off, right? So right now it's enabled. Another thing you can do is if you know that any of these sound devices, these microphones, are needing to have original sound every time you do these, let's say you're doing one weekly, right? You can go ahead and click that so that it will always be selected. Or when you select it here in the list of these microphones and such, as soon as you select it, it will make sure to turn on the original sound for you so you don't have to remember that next time. Okay, so that's pretty much it. Obviously, there's a couple of other things that you can do. I would highly recommend checking that the input levels stay no higher than this bar here. That is going to mean that you're close to peak clipping, and you don't want to do that for your users. Even if they say it's, not loud enough, they can turn the volume up on their side. There's another thing here that you're going to really want to pay attention to as well. So there's an audio statistics tab here. You want to make sure that this always says 32 kilohertz because that is the stereo sound. I know that sounds weird because, as DJs, we're used to, creating our podcasts and such in 44 or 48 kilohertz. 32 kilohertz is as good as Zoom is going to give you. So basically, you're going to want to make sure that that is high to 32. If you see it at 24 at any point during the meeting, and I would highly suggest that you have any of the hosts of the meeting checking this out for you, what that has typically mean is that someone in the meeting has their computer crashed or they've otherwise left the meeting and there's kind of an orphaned or a ghost user, that the host just needs to remove them. Or there's a possibility that someone has joined by telephone. Now, there's another option in here, I believe, that you can actually turn that off. And if you scroll all the way up to the very tippy top of this guy, notice here that there's an option to have telephone and computer audio. I believe that is the default. Go ahead and select computer audio, and you'll prevent that from happening. Well, I hope this has been informative, and if you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below. Thanks.